towards your left. Sir, आपकी लाइफ जो है काफी अप्स एंड डाउन्स वाली रही है, पिछले
रंगीन भी रही है.
होपफुली वो दत्त में देखने को मिलेगी. सर, मैं जानना चाहूंगा कि जब आप जेल से बाहर आए तो कितने बेताब थे कि आप स्क्रीन पर लौटे और शूट सेट के शूटिंग पर लौटे, क्योंकि आपकी लाइफ हमेशा से आपने इतने साल तक 35 साल की फिल्मों में काम किया है, तो कितना वेट कर रहे थे कि मैं पहली फिल्म में और पहले सेट पे पहुंचूं, और पहले दिन जब आप सेट पे पहुंचे तो क्या फीलिंग्स थी उस दौरान?
वह मैं बेताब तो नहीं था वापस सेट पे पहुंचने के लिए, क्योंकि दाल चावल मेरी बीवी ही दे देती थी खाने के लिए. और लेकिन मैंने ये जरूर सोचा था कि जो पिक्चर जो पहली आएगी, एक मैसेज हो, एक ढंग की पिक्चर हो, एक परफॉर्मेंस बेस्ड पिक्चर हो, एक पिक्चर जो मेरे बड़े भाई विनोद जी देखकर प्राउड हो, गाली नहीं दे, जो मेरी वाइफ देख के बोले कि बहुत अच्छी पिक्चर है, नहीं तो वो भी गाली दे देती है. और बाकी के जितने प्रिया भी गाली देती है, ये ओवन तो नहीं दे सकता बेचारा, लेकिन एक दो ड्रिंक के बाद में बोल सकता. लेकिन ये सब डेंजरस लोग बैठे हैं यहाँ पे भी ये लोग भी, वो परेश जी भी है, पंटी वालियान, बंसल साहब और बिट्टू. तो आई थिंक इसी वजह से मैंने बहुत सोच समझ के ये पिक्चर की.
रणवीर, एक सवाल आपसे है कि जैसे कि विधु विनोद चोपड़ा सर ने बताया, राजू ईरानी ने, और सब इंडस्ट्री के लोग काफी अरसे से सर को जानते हैं, संजय सर को जानते हैं, लेकिन कहीं मैंने पढ़ा था कि आपने एक बयान दिया है कि ये फिल्म करते वक्त मुझे जो कुछ संजय दत्त के बारे में पता चला वो मुझे भी नहीं पता था, तो कुछ शेयर करना चाहेंगे इस फिल्म में आप संजय दत्त बने हैं जो आने वाली बायोपिक?
मैं शेयर तो नहीं कर सकता क्योंकि विदु सर मुझे मार देंगे, बट जी मैं विदु सर को बचपन से जानता हूँ, लेकिन जब हमने बायोपिक पर काम करना शुरू किया तो मुझे हमेशा लगा कि ये एक्चुअली बायोपिक नहीं हो सकती, ये एक्चुअली एक साइंस फिक्शन फिल्म है, क्योंकि ऐसी लाइफ एक इंसान को जीना, मतलब आप मेरे समझ में ही नहीं आया कि ऐसी लाइफ कौन जी सकता है. मुझे एक्चुअली अभी कल की बात है, जब संजू सर ने मैसेज किया कि यू नो ट्रेलर लॉन्च पे आ जाओ, तो सडनली मुझे एहसास हुआ अरे यार ये तो मेरा ट्रेलर लॉन्च हो रहा है. फिर पीछे से एक दूसरे रणवीर ने मुझे टपली दिया और कहा कि तुम कभी संजय दत्त बन नहीं सकते, संजू सर का ट्रेलर लॉन्च है, दैट यू हैव टू गो एंड अटेंड. तो मैंने एक साल इनको इम्यूलेट करने की कोशिश की, प्रार्थना करता हूँ कि ठीक ठाक किया, क्योंकि ही इज अ वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट पर्सन नॉट जस्ट इन द इंडस्ट्री बट इन द कंट्री, यू नो समथिंग दैट वी ऑल कैन लर्न फ्रॉम हिज लाइफ, वी कैन टेक सो मच फ्रॉम हिज लाइफ. बट हाँ, जब मैं कभी सोचता हूँ बायोपिक के बारे में, इनकी लाइफ के बारे में, यही मेरे सोच में आता है कि ये साइंस फिक्शन फिल्म है, ये एक ड्रामेटिक या रोमांटिक फिल्म है.
Yeah, I think it was, and it was a important day for her, and we all miss her, and we all wish she was here, but it is her birthday, and I think this was the best day for this trailer to be launched.
So,
विदु जी मुझे मार डालेंगे. वो फिल्म तो आने दीजिए ना, आज तो भूमि की बात करते हैं, बिकॉज वो उसका वक्त आएगा जब हम बहुत बातें करेंगे उसकी. ऑल आई कैन से इट्स एन अमेजिंग लाइफ, एंड व्हाट इज मोस्ट अमेजिंग इज दैट संजू हैज बीन ब्रेव इनफ टू स्पेल इट आउट ऑनेस्टली टू अस, एंड इज नॉट स्केर्ड टू पोर्ट्रे यू नो अ लाइफ, a very positive life, or he's opened up the cards and he said aapko jo bolna hai bolo, meri zindagi aise thi. So I would say he's a very brave man. Biopics can be very one sided, but this is a biopic which is from all perspectives and it's a very open biopic.
Sanju,
don't you think you are too young to be Aditi's father?
Wow. Of course I'm young to be your father, but I'm just playing a character. You forget that?
Sanju sir, sir center mein. Sir, आपसे एक सवाल जानना चाहूँगा. जैसे सारे लोग बोलते हैं कि हर एक सक्सेसफुल मर्द के पीछे एक औरत का हाथ आता है, और जो भी आपके लाइफ में अप्स एंड डाउन आए, मान्यता जी ने बहुत अच्छे तरीके से उन चीज़ों को फेस किया, और ये जो पूरी जर्नी रही है आपके लाइफ की, या फिर ये जो आपके कमबैक आप बोल सकते हैं, तो इस बीच में उनका क्या रोल रहा या उनका क्या किरदार रहा, और इस फिल्म में जब आप कर रहे थे तो क्या उनसे कुछ एडवाइस लिया थे?
आपने बिल्कुल सही कहा है कि मान्यता जी ने हर पल हर लम्हा मेरा साथ दिया है और हमेशा देंगी, और एक दो ऐसी चीज़ें मुझे दी हैं जहाँ वो कोई दे नहीं सकता, इकरा और शारा. और इनसे बिल्कुल एक चीज़ सीखने में मिली है, वो गुस्सा. तो वो मैंने पोर्ट्रे किया है भूमि में शरद के ऊपर.
This is your first film after your release. Has your time, changed your working style in any manner?
I didn't get that. What was that?
So this is your first film after your release. So has your time away from the screen, the time you spent in jail, has it changed your working style in any manner?
I think my working style is the same. I mean, I don't hear a script. I don't watch the monitor. I don't look at the lighting. I don't look at the other artist, what he does. I mean, there's nothing changes, it's the same.
Sanjay sir, also in this film, there's this team of Save the Daughter, which has echoes of perhaps Beti Bachao. Do you think so? The dominant slogan, Beti Bachao.
Yeah, what about that?
So the film's theme is also Save the Daughter. And you know, this is a topic that everybody's talking about today.
I mean, you can say it says Save the Daughter, but it's more a film about a relationship between a father and a daughter. You know, and definitely I believe in Save the Daughter also.
Sanjay, when you heard the first time that the biopic will be made, were you a bit skeptical? Were you a bit worried or nervous? And also there were some reports that Ranbir was trying to meet him and meet you to do his research, but it was difficult to get in touch. Ranbir, you...
It'll take Ranbir 50 years to do research on me. You know, he's been a very, very special part of my life. Not because of the biopic, but just because of him growing up and his family's relation with my family and stuff like that. And if I was scared.
Were you a bit skeptical that what will be shown in the biopic? How
I was not skeptical at all, because Raju, me and Abhijat sat for many, many hours and I laid the cards right out in front of them. I've got nothing to hide. राज कॉमेडी सीरियल्स लिखता था, और यू नो, जब उसने ये पिक्चर लिखी, आई वॉज अमेज्ड एंड आई वॉज शॉक्ड कि इतना टैलेंट इस लड़के में है. कभी कभी बहक जाता है, लेकिन अभी क्या करें यार, वो होता है.
संजय सर, जस्ट नियर टू वर्ड्स योर लेफ्ट, सो हियर संजय सर, देयर वर रिपोर्ट्स सर, अपेरेंटली रणबीर एंड अनुराग बासु हैड अप्रोच्ड यू फॉर जग्गा जासूस एंड द रोल वाज इवेंचुअली प्लेड बाय नवाजुद्दीन सिद्दीकी. हाउ ट्रू वर दिस?
रणबीर गुड आंसर दिस. आई थिंक एवरी रोल दैट्स रिटन इन द हिंदी फिल्म इंडस्ट्री फर्स्ट गोज टू हिम ओनली. इट पासस थ्रू एंड देन इट फिल्टर्स डाउन. ऑफ कोर्स, you know, it was my first production, and it was a special appearance, and we wanted to carry it in the second part. And Basu Dada and myself thought there was nobody better than Sanju sir, but Sanju sir very gladly on the first time he heard it, he said, yeah, I'll do it. But there was some issue with, you know, the release of his first film and other stuff, but not this, maybe the next one. Of course, anything for you.
Sanju sir, have you seen the movie though? I mean, Jagga Jasus.
I beg your pardon?
Have you seen?
I haven't seen it yet. But I mean, I know it's a good. I saw the trailer, I loved it, but I'm going to see the film, and if I feel something is wrong, he knows what he's going to do.
Papa,
here
towards your left.
I hope nothing is shown, but that depends on Raju. Yeah.
Baba, it's good to have you back. The trailer looks amazing. Towards your left here. Left. Baba, it's good to have you back. The trailer is good. But do you think if you had come back with the Munna Bhai series, the comeback would have been perhaps, you know, a bigger comeback for you? Like, everyone is waiting for that movie. And do you think that comeback would have been a bigger one?
I think instead of asking me, there's my brothers out here and my another brother out there and the third brother sitting behind
me. ऐसा करिए मुड़ के वो पीछे वो जो बैठा है ना चुपचाप बैठा उसको ये सवाल पूछिए वो अभी भी लिख रहा है तीन साल से अभी हम लिख रहे हैं तो थोड़ा टाइम लगता है तो ये बैठा बैठा बोर हो रहा था अभी कितना उसको एक डेढ़ साल और बिठाते बोला भैया हम लिख रहे हैं जब पूछता है हो रहा है सर हाँ हो रहा है डायलॉग लिख रहे हैं हाँ लिख रहे हैं वो खामोश मैंने फिल्म बनाई थी उसमें डायलॉग राइटर को हमेशा पूछता था क्या हो रहा है जी कहता लिख रहा हूँ सर लिख रहा हूँ वो है पीछे बैठा उसको पूछो जिस दिन लिखेगा उस दिन नेक्स्ट डे शुरू हो जाएगी
ओके मेरा सवाल अदिति से है अदिति ट्रेलर इज लुकिंग यू नो एब्सोल्युटली फैंटास्टिक यू नो और अगर हम ट्रेलर को देखें तो बहुत इमोशनली इंटेंस किरदार में नजर आ रही हैं आप संजय जैसी शख्सियत के साथ यू नो इतने दिग्गज कलाकार हैं उनके साथ काम करना कितना चैलेंजिंग रहा आपके लिए पहला सवाल दूसरा सवाल कहीं इस बात का डर था संजय सर की वापसी थी यू नो उनकी उनकी कमबैक फिल्म थी कहीं ओवरशैडो ना जाए इस बात का भी डर था
आई थिंक हम सब वी ऑल लिव फॉर चैलेंजेस आई थिंक दैट मेक्स अस बेटर एंड दैट ऑलवेज मेक्स अस वर्क हार्डर आई थिंक एवरीबॉडी हु इज एन आर्टिस्ट एंड वांट्स टू परफॉर्म एंड वांट्स टू इज देयर फॉर दैट रीजन एंड लव सिनेमा वांट्स टू बी चैलेंज्ड एंड वांट्स टू बी पुश्ड एंड आई ऑलवेज फील You're a great actor in front of you makes you look better. And usually in a good film and in with amazing actors, they tend to be very generous people as well. So wo aapka kaam aur acha wo aapka kaam ubhar aasan kar dete hain they make it more beautiful. Wo nikharte hain aapko. And I think Sanjay sir was also the first day I think I was a little nervous and I'm usually not nervous but I was a little nervous because I didn't know Sanjay sir at all but he gave me a big hug and he said you're scared of me so that immediately sort of broke the ice and it was I think when the first shot was okay like Sanjay sir said it was because it was our scene together and the first shot was okay and we both breathed then I saw him doing the same and I was like oh, okay we're fine so it was I think that's what it is it's an amazing actor makes you better and a lot of the times I was bouncing off what he was doing he was acting and I was reacting to him so it's and every time he would do something different so it's always fun it keeps you on your toes and it makes it very natural Sanju sir also doesn't like to rehearse so that's great fun
hi Ranbir towards your left Ranbir hi this is Priyanka from Indian Express Ranbir even though you're not answerable for what your father says about your films or about people involved in your films but objectively speaking do you think that blaming the producer or blaming the director or music composer is right is fair after a film flops
when you see my father is a very emotional man you know I think whatever he said was to protect me in some way and is where he was coming from I don't necessarily agree with you know that he did that or that what he said like I said, Jagga Jasus is something that we worked for 3.5 years. We all were aware of what we were doing, how it was being made. Sometimes you succeed, sometimes you fail. But I don't look at it as a failure, I look at it as a learning. I think it's given me a lot. The experience of working with Anurag Basu again and everybody involved in the project. So yeah, you know, I can't answer for somebody else, but I don't necessarily agree with everything.
Also, I wanted to know that after the failure of Jagga Jasus we'll see you in that biopic. Is it a relief to work with a director like to come with a director like Rajkumar Rani, who's hit proof, or is it a pressure to actually be in the biopic after consecutive? I mean, after a flop.
But you know, it's a mix of both. Pressure, yeah. I hope that I don't break the chains. No, but to be honest, Mr. Rajkumar Hirani, not because of his, you know, the ratio of hits that he has, he's one of the finest filmmakers, the finest storytellers in the country. And because I've had the now opportunity to work with him, he works really hard on his scripts. He works really hard, very passionately. And there is no substitute to that. Having said that, there is no formula to success. You know, Anurag Basu and me worked on a film called Barfi before Jagga Jasus, which was quite successful. So aisa nahi hai ki, you know, if you work with this person, you guarantee success. If you work with this person, pata nahi kya hoga. films is something which nobody has cracked the formula to. But I'm just happy that I'm working with such amazing people. And I can do such amazing parts.
You know, just for record, I want to tell you that I came back from US and I went and I saw Jagga Jasus on a big screen. I spent 3.5 hours watching that film. And I think there are some moments in that film that are absolutely excellent. I want to put it on record.
Completely.
And also, also I want to clarify to you, he's not flop-proof. Nobody's flop-proof. We are not flop-proof. It's an absurd thing to say anybody's. Everybody's striving. Sometimes when you strive, it kind of falls into place. Sometimes you strive and it doesn't fall into place. And it's okay. Both ways it's okay. As long as you strive. And I've seen the kind of striving in Jagga Jasus, and I am here, I'll tell you why I'm here. Because I saw Mary Kong. Sanjay Bhansali's worked with me for many years. I called and I said, damn good film. And he said, sir, aapne toh meri kisi film ko nahi bola. This guy had directed that. That's why I'm here. When Sanju came to me, I said, who's directing? You said, this guy. I said, you must do this. So we are all striving, sweetheart. We may fail, we may succeed. Please don't judge us by that. Judge us by what Jagga Jasus is. Excellent. I want to say that. Sorry, it's a Bhoomi day, but I just have to tell you this. Like, this trailer is excellent. Jagga Jasus.
Last two questions. Please, let's take two questions regarding Bhoomi.
Please. Yeah, we're going
to.
Sanjay Dada Dipali here from TV9. And these people have so much biopic, I will see both of them later.
Sanjay Dada Dipali here from TV9 Marathi. Sanjay Dada here.
Sanjay Dada.
Sanjay Dada, who was your left? Hi, Dipali here from TV in Marathi. Jasa Ranbir, Ranbir-cha training and jasa looks pahile apan tumcha biopic sathi. Tar tumhi swatala Ranbir-cha yachat baghu shakta. Tumhi swataha as a Sanjay Dutt mhanun Ranbir-la tevda Ranbir-ne tevda nyay dila hai tumcha character-la asa vattay ka tumhala.
I don't know how to say it in Marathi, but I don't think this is a question that deals with Bhoomi. Is it? I think it's dealing with Bhoomi. So let's stick to Bhoomi. Can you ask me another, ask him something about Bhoomi, please?
She's asking, has Ranbir done justification?
We understood
that. I understand Marathi very well. Puja Sakala Sava Novasta shooting Jalu Aaye.
I have a question for Oman, sir.
Last question.
Yeah, yeah, yeah. Oman, sir.
Oman,
sir? Oh, really? I have a question for Oman, sir.
Yeah.
I want to ask you. How was your whole experience directing Sanjay sir and Bhoomi, and what do you think of their performance in the movie?
See, generally, I like to play with an actor in such a way that I want to take out stuff from an actor which he's never seen before in any other film. Be it Mary Kong, be it Sarabjit, and Bhoomi also is the same. But yes, I was nervous. I'm telling you, I was nervous to direct Sanjay Dutt, and because he has an aura. Okay, I had to break that aura and look at him as an actor. But the moment he comes on screen, you forget everything. Yeah, that's what he used to do. He used to say, and he used to make Aditi laugh completely. And I could hear on the headphones, what is happening? It's a serious scene. And so she used to giggle. That's the way Sanjay Dutt is. It's like he will break the ice and he'll make you most comfortable. And it was like, for me, a dream come true to direct. I didn't even think ever in my life I would be directing him. And thank you, sir. But really, the emotions on the scene, while editing also, we went through everything again. We feel the emotions.